Hi, I'm Valder Beebe, and I host the Valder Beebe Show on FM radio and internet television. I am famously known for That Celebrity Interview, which I conduct by cell phone, in studio, or satellite media tours. Go to ValderBeebeShow.com, YouTube.com/ValderBeebeShow, or our partnership network with Business in the Black, which is BlackSuccessAcademy.com. And click on the Valder Beebe Show channel. I'll see you there.
Being on the Valder Beebe Show today as I wrap up my day, Lori Jennings, who is the deputy editor at Good Housekeeping Magazine, and Dr. Jessica Alana, she's a medical doctor and a board-certified neurologist. Thank you, ladies, so very much, because it's really, really important. If I could start with you, Dr. Jessica, if you could set the medical platform for us.
Sure. So today we're talking about migraine, in particular chronic migraine. Migraine's a disabling disorder where you get headaches that come with light and sound sensitivity, stomach upset, and they usually get worse when you're walking around or moving. Chronic migraine is when you're getting headaches more than half the month. And these headaches come, again, about 8 days a month with more severe symptoms. The rest of the time, you might not have those severe symptoms or not. And it's occurring for 3 months in a given year or more.
Doctor, I'd like to know. I think many people have headaches. Is there a difference between a headache and a migraine headache?
Sure. So the difference between a headache and a migraine is that severity level and the symptoms that come with it. Most people, when you get a headache, you just get pain. You don't get any other symptoms. But having a headache with stomach upset, vomiting, light sensitivity, sound sensitivity, you just want to lay in a dark, quiet room and you want everyone else to go away. That's a migraine. That's the difference between the two.
Okay, even migraine has its own connotation. Chronic migraine, is that different from a migraine?
So chronic migraine, the difference between chronic and migraine, which we consider episodic, is something that's happening in frequency. So chronic migraine is more than half the month of headaches. At least 8 of those are severe or moderate to severe with light sound sensitivity, stomach upset. And that's occurring for at least 3 months in a given year.
Okay, excuse me, doctor. I'm going to switch to Lori Jennings just for a moment.
Sure.
You know, Lori, Good Housekeeping has partnered with Allegra on this initiative. This tells me it's really a sensitive issue.
Well, Good Housekeeping has partnered with Allergan on this initiative because...
I'm sorry.
That's okay. But first of all, it is Headache and Migraine Awareness Month. But secondly, we have a very broad audience that's mostly made up of women, and most of the people who suffer from chronic migraine are women. Women are 3 times more likely to suffer from the condition, and yet only 20% of people are accurately diagnosed. So there are a lot of people out there who are literally suffering in silence, who could have treatment, who could have better quality of life, but they're not achieving that yet. So our mission today is really to help educate people, to raise awareness, and then to encourage people to take the next step. If this all sounds familiar to them, get out there and talk to a medical professional.
This is Migraine Awareness Month. Will the magazine co-print anything on this? Can my audience go to the magazine also and find out more information?
Your audience can absolutely go to goodhousekeeping.com, where we have tons of information on migraines and headaches and prevention related. Another great resource is BotoxChronicMigraine.com. So that's a website where you can read personal stories from other people who have suffered from migraine. You can find out more about treatment as well as learn about signs and symptoms. And you can also put your zip code in there so that you can find a healthcare, or I should say a headache specialist near you. So that's really key.
That's good to make us feel comfortable. I'm going to switch to the doctor. Doctor, tell me, what is a headache specialist?
Here's one right here.
A headache specialist is somebody who's really focused their career in the sphere of headache. So an example, you know, I run the Georgetown Headache Clinic out in Washington, D.C., and all we see is headache all day. I'm board certified in headache medicine along with neurology, and many headache specialists go on to receive an additional certification in headache. That's really what's the difference to the patient. Your headache specialist, someone, this is, they live and breathe it just like you live and breathe the disease. So we're able to have that open dialogue about what's important to you, what are your symptoms, what's your diagnosis, and what's the best treatment options that are available to you.
There's so many medical breakthroughs. I think Hemingway said it's the best of times and the worst of times. There are a lot of treatment options out there. What's the difference between preventive treatment and actual dealing with the problem?
So preventive treatment is when the problem has become so significant, you can't deal with it anymore just by doing nothing. So you talk to your provider, they get you on something that helps reduce the frequency and severity of the disease itself. This is important once you're getting to having one migraine a week or more. It's imperative you have that discussion.
All right. Any recommendations for people who are listening that do have migraines?
Talk to your healthcare provider. Visit that website, BotoxChronicMigraine.com. Get more information. Information
All
is
right.
power.
I like that. Laura Jennings from Good Housekeeping, thank you so much. And Dr. Jessica, I want to thank you so much for talking about that. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.